I was backstage and I was hearing you guys talking so affectionately about me, and I was like, you know, a hug is in order.
You know? Did you get all teary and emotional in there?
Definitely, yeah.
Well, you know, one of the things that you have that I think turns a lot of people on is the fact that you got a 9.0.
Oh, wow.
Many, many, many times. How does that feel? And why are you aiming for this 9 so many times?
For me personally, because I teach the IELTS, I figure getting a 9 is, you know, the sense of validation that I needed, you know, to stand up there in front of my students and teaching them all these things. You don't really need a 9 to teach the IELTS, right? I mean, teachers do need to get to a certain level for sure, but I think a 9 was just sort of like my white whale.
White whale?
Yeah, being an IELTS teacher, that's what I always, you know, aim for.
Have you always been this prodigy, this you know, English speaking prodigy? Were you born with it, or did you have to overcome a lot of difficulties? If there have been any, could you share with us?
Prodigy is a little bit of an overkill. I went to English, you know, cram classes like most people, but I was never able to really excel. So for my entire academic life, so to speak, as well as my professional life, I've never really stood out or associated myself with, you know, English excellence or anything like that.
Really?
Yeah.
It's a bit hard to believe. So would you say that all of those experiences of yours, of, you know, encountering all these challenges of learning English as a second language, do you reckon all those things make you the teacher that you are today?
Definitely. I would think of myself as first and foremost a learner before I'm a teacher. The more I teach, the more I realize that I need to get taught. And it really pushes me to always keep moving forward, because I realize along the way that, I mean, there are so many people who are infinitely more talented than I am, and they don't even bother with the IELTS. You know, they have grander ambitions, right? Mm-hmm. So it's a really humbling experience.
You and I, we're both family men here, right? I keep wondering, you're obviously now you've become a bit of a famous, people recognize you, a lot of people look up to you. How is the wifey taking all that? And how do you manage between that and spending time with your loved ones?
My wife is extremely accommodating, and she's really understanding through all this. She manages the company, so, you know, she's taking care of the business side of things, so I can focus on the more technical, academic, boring. So yeah, I'm really fortunate to have a wife like that. And I don't know how she juggles between, you know, managing a company and managing a family, and she's still taking care of our daughter. She's a superwoman.
Aww, how do you guys feel about all that?